You ever seen moguls around here?
Are still blooming here.
Thank you. come. I have the cure for your chocobo's woes.
No one in these parts seems to know about the chaos infusions back at Canopus Farms.
Oh, it's all over for me.
Nadia, are you all right? What happened?
Que? Is that all you can say?
Oh, darn. I guess it didn't work. You were just pretending to be sick? Why would you do that?
Well, it's kind of an embarrassing story, but we're friends now, aren't we? I used to live in Yusnan, but I had a big falling out with my family, and I ran away from home. Back in the city, I was treated like a princess. I just had to snap my fingers to get whatever I wanted. But that's not real living, is it? I got tired of that life. I wanted to fend for myself, survive by my own skill.
But you didn't realize just how hard that would be.
I lasted 3 whole days before I collapsed in the woods, weak from thirst. And that's when this little guy came along just in time. He must have been injured too, because he was holding a Yule's flower in his beak. I thought to myself, I'm going to die, but at least I'll have this beautiful chocobo to watch over me as I go. But then, something even more incredible and beautiful happened. The chocobo spoke to me, as clear as I'm talking to you now. Hang in there, he said. You mustn't die. At first, all I could do was stare in shock. But then, his words began to sink in. I realized he was trying to save my life. Anyway, right after that, some villagers found me, and they nursed me back to health. But I'm sure that I wouldn't have been alive when they found me if it wasn't for my little chocobo.
You owe him your life.
Crap.
So that's what your little play acting was about. You thought if you could convince the chocobo that you were dying, he might start talking to you again, like he did the first time.
Yep. I was trying to recreate the scene just like it happened, with the Yule's flower in the beak and everything. And to be honest, I could do with a chocobo giving me encouragement again. Life has been getting me down. I thought if I could hear the chocobo talk again, he might cheer me up like the last time. I know it's stupid. Chocobos can't talk. Oh, I guess it was just in my head that first time.
It's all right. You'll find what you're looking for.
What?
Don't turn around. You're searching for meaning to your life, and you're going to find it. I know you will. In fact, maybe you already have, if you really, really think about it. Sometimes you lose your way. Sometimes the going gets so steep you fall, but the path is always there in front of you. You just have to keep going.
Yes! You're right. It is there, and I do see it. Thank you.
Who's that child?
Yes, what do you want?
I heard the chocobo talk. You're going to find it. I know you will. Huh. That was a clever trick you pulled, young man.
Young man? I'm a girl!
You are? Sorry, I didn't realize.
Good grief, everyone's the same! No one ever looks at me! It's like when I helped Nadia. The first time, I mean. She saw the chocobo, but she didn't see me on its back.
So that's what happened. It was you who spoke to her. She was half dead and delirious, so she thought it was the chocobo.
She's read way too many fairy tale books. But I guess it was kind of good it happened that way. Thanks to that, she wanted to go on living. So you can't tell Nadia the truth, okay?
Okay, agreed. What you did was good, pretending to be a chocobo and saying those things to her. She needed that. Wise words. Sometimes the going gets so steep you fall, but the path is always there in front of you.
Huh? I didn't say anything like that. What does it even mean? I just told her it's all right, or something like that.
Wait. Really? You didn't give a little speech?
No, weird. Maybe you both imagined it. Or maybe they can talk. It's our secret. Don't tell Nadia that it was me who was talking to her.
Thanks for everything. I've only been in this village for a short time, and before that, I'd spent my whole life in the city. I haven't been able to help anyone. Just the opposite. I've been nothing but a burden. And so I lost a lot of my confidence.
But now that confidence is back, right?
Thanks to you and the Chocobo.
Has the Chocobo talked again, since that time?
No, not a word. Why do you ask?
I was there, when it spoke the second time. I heard it just like you, and I still find it hard to believe.
I know. It still seems so incredible. Most people would just assume it's their imagination, or a trick.
But you believe it was the Chocobo.
You know, I don't think I care. Even if it was a trick, the words were the same, right? Whoever said them meant to help me. Talking Chocobo or not, that means someone is looking over me, and they care about me too. That much is true, if nothing else is. It took a little while to realize that, but once I did, I felt a lot better.
And, you know, it sounds like they were right, too. They said, you're searching for meaning to your life, and you're gonna find it. I know you will. Turned out they were right. And that much is true, too.
What'll it be? Come back soon.
You won't find better wares anywhere.
Hello, and welcome. Thank you kindly for your patronage.
Want to grow stronger?
Thank you.
good evening. Anyone who's not a hunter has to leave now.
Okay. Thank you.